So, welcome guys to my YouTube channel, because it's your first time here. Kindly subscribe from my friend. That is the border between Rwanda and Congo. Rwanda and Congo, that's the border. And you can see from here, this is Kigali. It's 150 kilometers, then Musanze is 50 kilometers. Then they're telling you, safe journey. So, I think filming there is not allowed, so I rather not try, because like I feel that would be a complete waste of time. And from far, I'm seeing that the trucks which are ferrying things from Rwanda, this is Rwanda, the other side is Congo. They have stopped for some security checkups, and as you can see, there are others there. So, guys, it's been a wonderful moment just being around here. And as you can see from my stretch, hey, Hotel Ubumwe, a very prestigious hotel. It's only for the rich. I think it's only the rich who can stay here. Maybe I can ask someone what's the relative cost of this place, so I don't know whether they will understand me. Hello, how are you? So, yeah, good. So, guys, it's beautiful just walking around here. You might mistake and think that I'm in Europe. And I'm not in Europe, guys. I'm in Kigali. No, like I'm in Rwanda. Kigali is a bit fast, 150 kilometers from here. And I've shot some videos about there, so along there. So if you really want to see how Kigali looks like, you might want to look at my previous videos. For now, I'm in Gisenyi, 50 kilometers away from Musanze. And that is the place I was before I came here. Got myself accommodation. And so now, I'd like to go back to my accommodation, which is a bit far. I've shot just a short clip of Lake Kivu. Lake Kivu is a very important lake here, because it feeds lots of people. It feeds lots of people in both Kigali, here like in Rwanda and in Congo. It has like 28 species of fish, and apart from that, it has like one specific species of fish which is called the sightridge or something. It's very unique, so it's one of the lakes which are important here. So the trucks are still coming. I think these are from now Congo. They are now arriving to Rwanda. And so I think I'm going to walk this way. There are so many trucks here, and but I have to keep walking. It's a marketplace, lots of things happening around here. The trucks being checked in some way. And so I have to continue walking this direction. It's lots of trucks. This is Tanzanian. So they are importing, I think they are the trucks which carry goods all the way from Tanzania and taking them to like Congo. You know, like Tanzania and Kenya, they have like an outlet in the Indian Ocean in a way. So they have like coastal cities where if things are important from abroad, they can arrive by the ocean. So that is the importance of having like friendship with countries, which is called economic integration. I'm still working in this very beautiful neighborhood over here. I think it's just the rich who stays here. This is not a place for the poor people. But on the same side, like in this part of the city, I've not seen like really the rich, the poor people. So it's like almost average to rich people. So guys, this is a Europe in Africa, the closest you can come. The weather is not very different from Europe. I think the temperature can be like maybe 8 degrees here. I think so. And it rains lots of time. It's a mountainous region. From my stretch, I'm seeing a building which apparently I think was consumed by fire some times back, but it has not been renovated. Of what I've heard about Rwanda, not just Kigali, it's very safe. Like you can walk with millions of money and no one will bother and no one will be like, will have any like intentions of taking your money. And that is a discipline that is, I think, is being taught around here. So that's something that is very unique about Rwanda, and it's very safe. Like you can walk with very expensive jewelries, very expensive cameras, like the one maybe I'm holding, and you just be feeling like you're safe. So this is one thing that you have to note about Rwanda. On the far end, I've seen it's Congo. I didn't go there because I kind of felt like I would just complicate the whole thing. And maybe I made a mistake because I would have gone to ask whether it's true Kenyans can visit Congo without visa, without applying for the visa. But anyway, it's what it is. Let me continue heading this way. Very cool neighborhood over here. The rich stays here in these accommodations. So I'm heading towards the town center. Where I live. And the beautiful thing is like, I don't know my accommodation. Can you imagine? Shortly after I was given the accommodation, I walked out very quickly because I was in a hurry. But I'll try to remember what I saw, and I'll get myself back there, I promise you. So I'm still walking. Lots of trucks still coming this way and going to the capital city. So it's really cool. I'm really enjoying walking around this beautiful neighborhood. And so from the look of things, I'm seeing some guys over there. But they're not going to stop me again, because every time I hold camera, I take myself to the police station somehow without even knowing. And that's something that is so interesting. But I usually predict it whenever I'm going to the police station. I normally predict it. If you've been following my videos, I normally predict that I'm heading to the police station somehow without even knowing. So this is called Steep Hotels. Steep Hotels. But of course, it's only for the people with money, not for everyone. So guys, you might want to like maybe visit here whenever you have money. Not for everyone. It's a very beautiful neighborhood. Tell me if you don't think this is Europe. The streets are maintained well. You will not see like papers like the way you see in Africa, like the rest of Africa, yeah? They have maintained the hygiene really well. So I believe like hygiene is very important here. There are people who are employed, from what I heard and what I've seen, the people whose work is just like to sweep the roads and the streets to make sure that they are clean. You can see like it's really clean. Shout outs to His Excellency Paul Kagame, the President of the Republic of Rwanda. He's done a pretty much good job raising this country from the genocide to the most peaceful country, the safest country in Africa. This is not a joke. So this is my stretch. I'm supposed to follow that road. I'm not sure how I came, how we came, because I was in a motorcycle. And I was talking to this guy, so he was just taking corners. So I'll just make some guesses, or if I find someone there, I'm going to ask them. Look at the beautiful flowers over there. They are pinkish and reddish, and some are purple. They're making the compound really beautiful. Look at this. It's amazing. The mountains over there, they're stretching. And the gates were preserved. It's amazing, just walking around here. The time right now is like 6 p.m. I guess, or maybe 5:40. and it looks as if it's like nighttime, but it's in the evening anyway. So I'll follow this boda right. This seems to be the way to the city center. That makes sense. As you can see, lots of birds are flying over the sky. Tell me how you feel, guys. If you're new here, can you subscribe? Because we're still moving on, and this seems like our last day here. We'll be going to a different place tomorrow. I'm enjoying just walking around from here to the city center. From where we were to the city center is approximately 500 Rwandese franc, which you can say like it's like 60 or 70 Kenya shillings maximum. And so I'm not really sure. Is town center, is this way or this way?
Town.
Yeah. This way?
Yeah.
Thank you very much. All right. Yeah. So yeah, I was right. The town center is towards this way. Man, I don't want to get lost. The reason why I asked. But then at the same time, I'm kind of very good when it comes to guessing and making good probabilities. So here we go. I'm feeling really tired, but I have to do this. It's just a beautiful moment just walking around. The night time is approaching. I don't know why. Feeling as if it's like during the fall season. But the leaves are not falling, so it's like maybe the winter. But at the same time, the trees have their leaves. So it's a common phenomenon. It's a very unique phenomenon over here. The taxi, I think, is taking the guy towards the border between Rwanda and Congo. Beautiful neighborhood. So you might want to subscribe if you haven't. Still insisting. I've been showing you like lots of places in my YouTube channel. It's like pure raw vlogs of places that you've not visited, or you've visited and maybe you didn't come this way, or you would like to visit. So watch out for this. These are the African episodes, so these are focusing mostly on Africa. In later times, we're going to focus on better places, maybe, if you think this is not better places. But for me, I love Africa, so feel it. So let me continue walking down. Some people are coming this way. I don't know how they will react to a camera, so let me just flip over the camera and face myself. Yeah, I know like there are reactions which I'm expecting, and so I like to keep focused. And even though like most of the people don't want to be filmed, whenever like they pass, they have to look behind. That is something that is very common. And so from the far, I'm seeing Sonarwa General. I don't know what is that, what that is, but on the same side I'm seeing Bank of Kigali. I think it's a very common bank over here. It's the main bank. I don't know whether it's the central bank. So if you see my legs have started aching, but I have to keep walking. The good thing, I don't have a backpack. Left it in my accommodation, then I forgot where my accommodation is. And so I'll try to get myself back to the accommodation. Then after I get myself to back to town, then after that I get my accommodation. Then I'll go get something to eat. Then after that I'll sleep, get prepared for tomorrow, another journey. So it's like continuous journey. I'm not sure what this is, so I'm trying not to film around without knowing what I'm filming. This is a school of automobile technology. So, but anyway, it goes without saying like I'm supposed to head straight. So guys, yeah, so continue walking this direction. seems very promising. So the guys are from the wedding, so they are going to some reservation somewhere. So it's pretty amazing.
Pretty amazing.
So across the road, lots of people. It's on a Saturday, and you know, like most of the wedding, they normally take place during Saturdays. This is called Wazi Restaurant. Wazi Restaurant.
I remind you, I'm in Gisenyi. Gisenyi, which is in the northern part of Rwanda somewhere. But the most northern part I've seen, I think, is Musanze, place I was before. So I'm sorry if I'm mispronouncing it. I'm not Rwandese, so Kinyarwanda is also foreign to me. So this is really good. Looks really interesting. And so here we are. Looks like this is the place I was before. But I know exactly whenever I get to the place where they had some wedding. So it's getting dark really quickly. And so I have to increase my speed and make sure like I'm moving with the right speed, which is important, or which is like needed. Which is necessary. So guys, it's been like 16 minutes of street shooting. Getting cold, my hands are getting cold, but not really as much. It's been like beautiful just walking around here. And so I'll film like next 4 minutes. So that would be like 20 minutes of street shooting, just showing you around the city, how it looks like. So that whenever you come here, you know like what to expect, or maybe even before you come here, you'll be really prepared. This is a district through Rubavu. Yeah, so Gisenyi is in Rubavu district. And I'm sorry, like most of these names, I can't pronounce them really well. So I'm trying to walk around. It's a district, Rubavu, as you can see. It's beautiful just walking around here. I'm seeing a flag which is not really good to my videos. Whenever I see flags, I'm worried because there'll be like a policeman to stop me and ask me what I'm doing. So, which is a good thing because they're maintaining the security. I'll emphasize this. And I'll continue emphasizing that because without these guys, there will be no security. And so you might want to respect them a lot. They have maintained the security of this place to a point that you can just walk with millions and no one will follow you at all. So guys, it's like really beautiful. Just walking around, I came by a bike, but then here I am. This is Hillview Hotel. And I think I can just walk around, just show you how the place looks like. Hopefully, like I'll be allowed to just get in. But you know what, like, I don't know whether filming is allowed here, so I'll just go, ask whether it's allowed, if it's not allowed. That's okay. I've shown you, like, how the place looks like. So it's not like you haven't seen it, but mostly I wanted, first of all, to ask people how the cost of the boats and everything. And you've seen for yourself the package. If you haven't, you might want to check that video. I've not posted it yet because I'm still around. So just came to just see how the place looks like. So guys, so I don't know whether I'll be stopped again. It's really bad whenever like I'm trying to do something and then there is someone stopping me because of some things. So, but one of the things I know I'm trying to do is just to avoid filming, because it's not really good. You can't film people. So here we are, it's Hillview Hotel, Lake Kivu. And I'm not sure whether we can get the other side. I'm not really sure. So the only thing you can do is just to stick around this lane and see how it looks like. It's really beautiful. You can close over from what I'm seeing. It's just like this beautiful lane where you can just walk and just be, enjoy the place. So guys, I don't know where the filming is around here. So I think what I'm going to do, I'll just stop this video or maybe walk a little bit, maybe up to that place, show you around, and after that I'll just end the video and just call it a day. I don't think filming there is allowed, so I'd rather just continue walking and just walk by the sea. Hello, is entering there free?
What?
Yeah, it's free?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, thank you. All right, thank you very much. Okay, so guys, I've been told like you can enter for free, so let me take you across Lake Kivu around so that you see how it looks like. Hello. So I'll just pass through here. Okay, thank you. So here we are, guys, Lake Kivu. So it's really beautiful. Okay. Just walking by the sea, by this lake. It's really, really beautiful. Really beautiful. And I'm enjoying this. I don't know whether I should come closer because it's very important that maybe you see how the place looks like. This is not like the Indian Ocean, this is Lake Kivu. It's so way different. But its beauty is different. So guys, look at my amazing view. And lots of tides here and there. I told you, like the deepest part of this lake, according to Google, is like 480 meters, which is approximately half a kilometer deep. That's what I mean, the depth. And then it is a house to like 20 to 28 species of fish. And the most unique type of fish is the cichlids. They have like the Nile tilapia, but cichlids are the most unique because they are only found here. People come to walk around here. This is a therapy, really beautiful. And I think I'm going to take you to that bridge over there, if it's free. Of course. But if there is payment, then man, have to come for yourself and pay. So I want to take you to maybe that stretch over there. It's like 30 meters in my approximation, like 30 to 50 meters maybe. Not really good in that. Or is it because I'm wearing this? Or maybe because I'm dumb. So let's see what this place have to offer. After this, I'll be ending my video right there. So after I take you across, and then I go to the city center, find my accommodation, and then wait for the next day and go to a new destination. So guys, it's amazing. This is beautiful. Those guys are hugging well, man. I know it's like gazing or something. It was really nice, man. So where I come from, like most guys cannot hug, like it's really not allowed, like not really allowed by the society, but it looks as if it's a taboo or something. So look at this. I wanted you to look at this. It's amazing. Like just down here is water. Just down there is water. It's kind of a bridge if you saw it from a distance. And hello. So in here we have like photographers who can take you good pictures around if you wish. And I think from here you can also dive. Look at this.
upstairs, but I don't want to go down there. I'm a swimmer, but then I don't want to test myself on with these rocks, because if the tides are so strong, they can grab you to the wall. So it's really nice. Feeling as if this is not really strong enough to hold people. So like it's shaking. Here for my stretch is Congo. That side is Congo. And this side is Rwanda, but here I'm standing, I'm in Rwanda's territory, so yeah, so that you know, this is Lake Kivu. It provides like more than 200 tons of fish every year, and it feeds both these countries, Rwanda and Congo, with fish, so it's very important. And then the lake, according to what they say, that the lake is in danger because of the volcanoes and everything. So it's like there's a mission of carbon dioxide and something like sulfur or something, magnet or something. So this is endangering the lake. So apparently like 411 people died as a result of this water. So you can search that on Google, what it's called, the Killer Lake, and see the information that will pop up. Just something I read way back, I'm trying to remember. And so guys, these are the boats. You have the charges. So if you really want to know much about the charges, I made a clear and a detailed video about that, because I asked someone some questions who is a captain and who rides these boats, and they explained everything. So it was in English, so you don't have to be worried. And so guys, I think that's a good history and a tour that I've taken you today. If you're new here, kindly subscribe, and I'll continue with my journey. I hopefully like you like the video. Kindly like this video after watching, and watch my other videos as well. So tomorrow I'll be heading to another destination, so look out for that, and I'll see you in the next video. So peace and love.